Hey everybody, and welcome back to another Redstone video. Today, I will show you how to build yet another gambling machine. I call this one the Tower of Luck. Let me show you how it works. In order to play, all you have to do is to just put some diamonds into this shulker box right there, and then hit the button. As you can see, one diamond gets taken out, and essentially you have a chance of 50% of getting this first prize. Then once you get that, there's once again another 50% chance for the next prize, 50% chance for the next one, and so on. So essentially there is a chance of 1 in 2 for the first prize, 1 in 4 for the second one, 1 in 8, 1 in 16, 1 in 32, 1 in 64, and so on. Now obviously you don't have to use the same items as I am right here. You can fully customize pretty much everything about this gambling machine, from the percentages to the items themselves. This idea actually came up on my Discord server a while back, so if you also want to hang out with other people from my community, feel free to join that one. On there we are also starting up a Java 1.16 community SMP, so if you're interested, feel free to apply. A link to the Discord can be found in the video description. First off, I will show you how to build this base model right here, and then I will show you how to extend it layer by layer. You can pretty much make this however high you want, but obviously at some point the probability for getting the upper items gets so low that it's pretty much impossible. By the way, I have made sure that this not only works in the Java edition, but also in Bedrock. Let's take a look at how to build it. You want to start off with an at least 3 wide space. This floor right here needs to be at least 5 blocks long, and for the 2 base layers this wall needs to be at least 3 blocks high, and then for every layer you add you will also need an additional block right there. Also you will need a 6 blocks long space behind this wall, and also 2 blocks of space below the floor. Okay, first off, just knock out these 2 blocks right here and just place a redstone lamp in this position with a button on top. And below that, you now want to place a dropper facing in this direction with a hopper connected to it, facing into it. And now just place 2 non-stackable items into this dropper. And then coming out of the dropper, you want to place a comparator, like so, going into a block. Then just 3 more blocks like so, another block right there, and then just place redstone dust on top of these 3 blocks. Now you want to just come down here and place a barrel in this position with a comparator on top of it, then a hopper going into this comparator and another hopper going into the barrel. In front of that comparator you now want to place 2 blocks like so, another block right there, redstone torch, and then 2 bits of redstone dust on top of these 2 blocks. Go to the side and place another block right there, redstone dust on top of that one, then a comparator right there going into a block, yet again another comparator in this position, another block, and then from the side you want to place 3 diagonal blocks like so with redstone dust on top of these 2 blocks. And now just come to these 2 hoppers right there, and into the upper hopper you want to put 23 diamonds like so, 1 into every slot, and then an additional 18 into the first one, and 1 diamond should get sucked down into the lower hopper. And now just take a shulker box, you can in theory also use a barrel, and place it in this position. Now just knock out these 3 blocks and place a slab right there. And behind that, just for decoration purposes, you want to place another block with 2 droppers on top of it. Then next to this dropper right there, you want to place a note block, and also a note block right there. You want to hit this one 6 times, and this one 8 times. The way you can check this, at least if you're playing in the Java edition, is just to press F3 and look at the note block. And on the right hand side it should say Note 8, and for this one Note 6. And now in front of these notebooks, just place some redstone lamps. Go to this block right here and just place trapdoors and jump twice. And then you can close these like so and just place item frames attached to them. And in the back, you just want to place a emerald block right there with a notebook on top of that, and then just click this one 10 times. Now just place a dropper right there facing in this direction with a hopper going into it, a block right there, and then two additional blocks in these two positions, a comparator taking an output from this hopper going into a bit of redstone dust, then another block right there, redstone dust on top of it, and then just place three blocks in this kind of shape with two repeaters facing in this direction and then another repeater in this one. And if you're playing on the Bedrock edition, you want this repeater right there to remain on one tick, but if you're playing in Java, you want this one to be on two ticks of delay. And then just place a pumpkin right there with a note block on top of it. Now just go back to this bit of redstone dust right there and place a transparent block on top of it. You can also use an upside down half slab for example. And just place a bit of redstone dust on top of that one. Then take an observer taking an output from this bit of redstone dust, going into a block with a 3-tick repeater right there, yet another block, and then a dropper with a hopper facing into it, like so. And then just yet another block, two more blocks right there, and another block in this position. Place a comparator right there, and then two bits of redstone dust right there. And now the last step for the base layer is to just put a non-stackable item and a stackable item and a non-stackable item into these droppers right there. Okay, now let's go over how to add new layers. First off, you just want to extend this wall, so just place a block right there, a note block right there, then a dropper, yet another trapdoor in this position with once again an item frame right there, then just place a note block in this position, and for the third layer you want this one to be on 10. Once again, just check with the F3 screen, seems to be correct. And now the way you wire up this third layer is to just come to this latest bit of redstone dust going into this note block, and just once again take an observer output from it going into a block with once again a 3-tick repeater going into a block, a dropper, once again a hopper, and into that dropper once again put a stackable and a non-stackable item, a block right there, another comparator, just another block right there, and then two bits of redstone dust. And that should be everything for this layer. And now if you want to add an additional layer, it's basically the same thing but mirrored. So let me just do that real quick. Place a block right there, redstone lamp, dropper, then just another trapdoor with an item frame attached to it. And then on the other side this time you want to place once again a note block, and this one you want to click 11 times. Once again, just check with F3, seems to be correct. And now from this bit of redstone dust, just take an observer output going into a block with a 3-tick repeater, yet another block, dropper hopper, and then just take a stackable and a non-stackable item and put it into that one. Block right there, comparator, yet another block in this position, and then just two bits of redstone dust in these two positions. And now we have four layers. And obviously you can now add as many as you want with the exact same pattern which I just showed you. When you have now built up your tower to your desired height, -6, so I just added two more layers, you can now just close it up at the top so that no items actually somehow make it over the top. So just have a block right there. And then also when building the tower higher, you want to make sure that the nodes actually go up in pitch. So this one is on node 11, you would want your next notebook to be on 13, this one on 15, and then this one on 17, this one on 18, this one on 20, this one on 22, and then this one on 23. But only obviously if you're building up the tower that high. Okay, now let's just add all of the items to all of the item frames and also to the droppers behind them. Keep in mind that you will need more of the items at the bottom because obviously the player gets them more often. Okay, if you have non-stackable items in here, such as this book for example, there's also another little trick which you can do. Just go to the back, to this book right here, or just to the non-stackable item, and just place a hopper going into it with a chest, and then you can just add more storage basically by just adding more books. And if I would now get this book, one book of this chest would get sucked out, and obviously you just have more books to choose from, and you don't have to refill the books that often. Okay, there's also another little trick which I wanted to show you. If you want to make the top item, for example, ultra rare, sort of as a jackpot, you can just come to the back and add more stackable items to this dropper right here. Just make sure that they don't actually stack, and you have 9 individual items in this dropper right there. And now, it would randomly choose one of these items, and every time it chooses one of these non-stackables, this one wouldn't get activated, so it's just ultra rare basically for this Elytra to be chosen now. Okay, now let's check if this actually works. Just go to this shulker box right there and put your diamonds into it. Then just hit the button. And I just got a single bit of iron. I didn't win anything, then okay, this time it got up to the gold. Oh, diamond. Okay, but as you can see, it works now, and all of the diamonds which are inserted by the user will now end up in this chest right here. And now obviously you can just take out your diamonds, and yeah. That's it for today's video. I hope you enjoyed, and I will see you in the next one. Goodbye.